Laurence is absolutely fantastic. There's not a feeling in the world like it's brilliant. And it's so magical this year, to see everybody kind of back again. You know, last year was terrific because we had a lot more people back at the concerts, but there's a real sort of buzz in the streets of Edinburgh this year. It's wonderful, really wonderful. So wherever you've travelled from, it's totally brilliant to see it. And it's brilliant to be back in this lovely space again. I kind of set myself a bit of a challenge with this concert. And that was, I thought, well, for the people who are maybe just here this week in Edinburgh, or maybe even just here for this one concert, this is the only Scottish music that we'll hear, wanting over the next hour or so to try and make it as kind of varied as possible. So you've got a really good sort of feel of the whole geography of Scotland and beyond. And for those of you who are staying for longer, I thought, well, it would be good to just give a sort of flavour of what's to come, because I'm doing a series of concerts this year at Fringe. And four of them in this lovely space, one of them over on the Carangay and on the Mile. And I thought it would be really nice to, for those of you who are staying around, celebrate those concerts in a sense by giving you a little taste of. So, a lot of the themes tonight, Robert Burns in particular is going to feature next week, and a couple of concerts down here. The Islands is going to feature throughout, and you'll see there's some American music in the programme as well, particularly in the Carangay Kirk on the 20th of August. That's going to be a kind of big celebration of 20 years of my trio with Ian Drysdale and Ian Crawford. So we're going to kind of look back over a lot of the tracks recorded over the 20 years. And Bill Monroe featured right at the very start of recording output. So I thought at that concert, but indeed tonight, you know, to represent America and Ireland in the programme. No better person to have with me than this gentleman here, Lawrence Wilson. And Lawrence has been a concert. Those of you who are fiddle and piano junkies, the one in the Acoustic Music Centre, there's two performances with Laurence and the composer of this next tune we're going to do, Jennifer Wrigley, a lovely tune called James and the Kirkness. And I'm going to do you a couple of kind of older tunes from Orkney, Jimmy the Booze. The Booze is a farm one, it's not a Jimmy the Booze, Polka, and Stronsay Beaver. So this is kind of, to get the geographical thing running immediately from Ayrshire, right up to Orkney, and then we'll explore in between. So lovely to see you all, and Laurence is going to lead us off in this lovely tune.
Thank you.
Island would be to let you hear a few strathspeys in a row. Very often, you know, we would do like a march strathspey and reel, or maybe a couple of strathspeys in a reel. But this next set, I thought, particularly for those of you who are from outside Scotland, it may be nice just to hear three very different strathspeys. And of course, the rhythms of each are quite similar, the dotted rhythm or the snapped rhythm, as we call it in Scotland. But they're all very, very sort of different characters. That's what I love about all these tunes. You know, they're very sort of similar in size and length, you know, and very kind of similar patterns rhythmically. But they all have very individual characters. And something that's always intrigued me too is back in the 18th century, they're very often named after people. You know, it's sort of like maybe a wealthy sort of lord from a castle somewhere decides to get a tune written for his wife. And quite often William Marshall and Robert McIntosh and these people, they would write tunes specifically on request from people. So this next set, I thought it'd be lovely to kind of have it taking you to opposite ends of the country to kind of come into kind of the Perthshire of Edinburgh, or all that kind of area, but back in the golden age of fiddle music, the 18th century. So the first tune, though, I think we've all got access to printed programmes. I always think it's good nowadays to have that so that you've got a sort of written record of the tunes. Miss Campbell of Saddle, lovely strathspey by Robert McIntosh. Robert McIntosh worked in Edinburgh for a lot of his working life. He's sort of led the orchestras here, and he taught the final go. The person who wrote the third tune on the set was taught in part by Robert McIntosh. And Nathaniel Gow also worked in Edinburgh in the publishing industry. And the middle tune, William Marshall, it's a glorious tune. Well, Marshall's Focke was up right on the sort of banks of the Spey. They named the tune the banks of the Spey. The Focke was sits just, I think it's on the east side of the River Spey. And he had access to that whole sort of wonderful culture of the River Spey and the inspiration that it brought. So I'm going to do these three strathspeys and then into a slip jig by Neil Gow. The slip jig, interesting thing because it's found a lot in Irish music. There's not so many examples in Scottish music, but this Marcus of Barley is one of the great slip jigs in the Scottish repertoire. So I thought it'd be nice to go straight into that after the strathspeys and let you hear the difference in rhythm. And then I'm going to do a great Neil Gow reel from Kelly Armitage. He was from a little place called Inver, Neil Gow, right next to Dunkeld, along the River Tay. And Dunkeld Hermitage is a lovely bit of woodland in that part of the world. And, it's a lovely, it's a glorious reel. And also, in terms of the quality of these tunes, hopefully it kind of opens the ears to the various types of scales and sounds contained in the tunes. I hope you enjoy this.
Thank you.
met the day before the concert, so there was quite a big risk involved on his part. I knew it would be wonderful, but I thought, does he know what he's getting himself in for? You know, like, I'm going to turn up his house and all, and I'm literally going to be anything, but he's going to love to do this. It's absolute joy to play music with him. Neil Gow, one of the great tunes of all time. You know, like, I often think about all the great music that was around all over the world at that time. Mozart, Haydn, Beethoven, Schubert, all the same period of history. And yet that melody, I think, has to rank up with the best in the world. And it's a glorious tune. One of the big things with these tunes, all of them, is the way that we sort of travel and the way the tunes of other countries have become part of our culture here in Scotland. And I thought it would be lovely to play a couple of Irish reels. And these reels, just to give you an example of the way they travel, I've played them since I was, you know, a puppy in the Ayrshire fiddle orchestra when I was 8 years old or whatever. My dad played them on the accordion. And I had no idea at the time they were from Ireland, you know, so a lot of the tunes actually come over and we play them without any real understanding of where they're from. So I think that's wonderful, the tunes sort of travel so well. So we're going to do a couple of Irish tunes, and then I'm going to do a little tune that I wrote myself all the way to America. I've been a few times to America. In 2013, I went over there with a group called the Scottish and Song to do a frequent tour, mainly of classical music, although I played quite a bit of folk music over there as well. And I was thinking on the plane over about all these Scottish and Irish people from the past who've gone over to America and in search of a new life. And I felt really sort of sad. I was going over for a few weeks. And you know, you feel that sort of sense of poignancy when you, even for that short period of time, I thought, James, these people are gone never to come back again, you know. And so I wrote a little tune called Leaving for America. And it's on, I brought out a new album last year called The Tunes of the River. And this tune actually had the great privilege of recording it with a brilliant piper called Rob Wallace, who many of you know from Whistlemakers band. So Rob's kind of played the melody on the pipes. On the album, but Laurence has a tremendous version of on the piano, so we're going to play these couple of Irish tunes and leave it for a minute. Thank you. mentioned earlier on that the music of America, particularly Bill Monroe and the bluegrass boys, has always been a great inspiration to me. And then about 20 years ago, when I started recording fiddle tunes, again, as I mentioned, with the trio with Ewan Drysdale and Ian Crawford, we put quite a lot of American tunes, both in the set lists and recordings, and then the concert we're doing in the Canongate on the 20th of August. There's a track that we do a very sort of interesting version of on the Alice album, Closer to Home. Ian, in particular, the bass player, was a big Jeffrey Tull fan. We were all in real, you know, prog rock, you know, prog folk fans in the Fairport. And it was absolutely fascinating to see what he did with, you know, a lot of these tunes. You know, it was incredible, and we ended up doing some versions of them, you know, that I probably wouldn't repeat now, you know, but it's fantastic sort of thing, back to them all. But anyway, one of them, a tune called Sailed Man, and you play the fiddle, and we recorded it on the Closer to Home record, and if you want to come to Canongate on the 20th, you'll get a bit of a more psychedelic version of it. Of Sailed Man, it's such a brilliant tune. And before it, one of my favourite Bill Monroe tunes in Lonesome Moonlight Walks. So many great recordings of this piece. I love listening to Kenny Baker, the Bill Monroe's fiddle player from his band. And there's so many great recordings of it. So this is for all you Americans out there. Welcome to Scotia's Bleak Domain, and here's a song.
Thank you.
one below, we'll maybe have a chance to go on a wee bit, maybe play another one after that. If anybody's, I won't be offended if anybody's got other shows running off to or whatever, but we'll maybe do one more. So, yeah, it's just been more of a plenty tonight. Honestly, this room is fantastic. It's such a buzz coming back home and playing Edinburgh again. It's lovely to see it so busy. For those of you who are staying on Edinburgh for a few weeks, I hope you've had a great time. It's lovely to see you again. You see downstairs the CDs for sale. They're all £10 each. But you've various options. If you've got cash with you, you want to buy CDs, that's fantastic. I've got a card machine if anybody doesn't have cash, or if you're coming back to more stuff in all seasons and you don't have cash with you, you're very welcome to take it tonight. Just say Alan downstairs, you can bring next time you're coming back. I mean, I'm a big believer in everybody getting the music, So even if you don't have cash and you don't want to use the card machine, take them, and if you're coming along with something, or you can pop back in and see it in the festival, so probably it's great. Anyway, the CD's there. Big thanks to Laurence. I thought we would finish the programme with and Jim Scott Skinner for a number of different reasons. I mean, these tunes are so powerful by the self-titled strathspey king. In all honesty, when you put them anywhere else in the programme, it's very difficult to follow on because they're such powerful tunes. The other reason, two reasons I thought for doing them, aside from the fact that they're brilliant tunes, what I said at the start, I'm trying to tie in some of the programmes. The final concert I'm doing in here is with a brilliant cellist, Alice Allan, who's from the same hometown as Jim Scott Skinner in Bankhead. So I thought, again, we'll be featuring some Skinner at the end of the festival. It's a nice way of tying in the concerts. But also, thirdly, from Ayrshire to Orkney, I looked online, that's the sort of anorak I am, this stat I'm going to give you. I looked and I saw from my hometown at Drossel, the Bankhead is 154 miles. And from Cuthbert to Orkney, the Bankhead is 170 miles. So I reckon from Ayrshire to Orkney, about a halfway point on the Scottish Fiddle map, we got the Bankhead and James Scott's there. So we'll do these for you. It'd be great to for you. Queen's welcome for another call, end of call. They learn and love it. And a great skin of real spay and spade. takes his call from Ayrshire to Orkney, takes it above Orkney and it's Shearer. So we're going to even higher to give you the full Scottish picture. It's a lovely tune called One and Laurence. And it's written by a gentleman called Frank Jameson, a great Shearer composer. And I thought it was to play it in the first instance. It's a favourite tune of my father's. My dad, I'm talking to the Fringe concert in Edinburgh. He's not going to be this year, but it's a favourite tune of his. So we're going to dedicate it to my dad. Also, equally, we lost the great Robbie Shepherd recently. And this tune, actually, when I heard it as a little boy, I was sitting with my dad listening to Robbie Shepherd on the radio. And I was eating Howie that played the tune. So the first version I heard of it was Robbie. So I'd like to dedicate